Victoria said, an onstage question, Miss Tsunami. Ladies and gentlemen, let's pray for Victoria. She has been shut out tonight. She left me. My cat's dead and I've been abandoned. How rude. Y'all still doing all right out there? Y'all will have to forgive me. I'm a little crazy. I'm the crazy old lady up here tonight, okay? Next to Nicole, so just work with me. Just work with me, folks. Gentlemen, make some noise at this time. An evening gown competition for contestant number 13.
Contestant number 32 in evening gown competition, Miss Gay DC America, Cody Collins. Cody comes to us from the city of Raleigh, North Carolina. Her sponsors include Robert York, Legends Nightclub, Kirby Colby, Jeff Coble, Vicki Williams, Lindsay Starr, Denise Russell, Bridget Nichols, LaWanda Jackson, and many family and friends.
She says that as she gets older, she feels more comfortable with herself. And she says the worst beauty advice she was ever given was, you should try the natural look. That's just the light eyeliner and lip gloss.
Cody is most worried about not spending enough time with her family and friends. Positive attitudes make her happy, and empty showrooms make her sad.
Victoria, would you please stop patting my rear end? I would appreciate that. Thank you very much. That's my husband's job. My favorite line or quote from a movie is, the only thing that separates us from the animal world is our ability to accessorize.
The movie title that best describes her life is Dr. Doolittle. And the song written that best applies to her life is I Dreamed a Dream.
She says that positive attitudes make her happy and that an empty showroom makes her sad.
In her female persona, she's sometimes mistaken for Miss America. And as she gets older, she feels more comfortable with herself. Ladies, gentlemen, and judges in evening gown competition, this is contestant number 32, Miss Cody Collins. And we're going to bring Vicki Vincent out to ask the onstage question.
Thank you, Victoria and Katia. Good evening, Cody. You look beautiful. How are you?
I'm doing well.
Well, good. You look well. What I'd like for you to do is just tell us a little bit about yourself, and then I'll give you your question, okay?
Thank you. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, judges. My name is Cody Collins, and I come to you from Raleigh, North Carolina. Yes. 25 years ago, I had a goal. The road has been long, but not without purpose. Tonight, I thank you for letting me achieve my dream. Thank you so much. My name is Cody Collins.
Very good. Now, if you'd like to choose a question, and you may open it, read it to yourself, and then I'll read it for the audience, okay? Cody, your question reads, as Miss Gay America, a portion of your responsibilities will be administrative duties. What are three most important skills of a good administrator? I'll read it once again for you. As Miss Gay America, a portion of your responsibilities will be administrative duties. What are three most important skills of a good administrator? Good luck.
Thank you, Vicky. The three most important administrative skills would be a good listener, a good teacher, and a good advisor. And I think that I could handle all three. Thank you so much. My name is Cody Collins.
Take one more walk. Ladies and gentlemen, give it up for Cody Collins. Congratulations. Thank you.
Ladies, gentlemen, and judges, in evening gown competition, this is contestant number 36, Miss Tatiana Vauché.
Way to deflect, girl. Way to deflect. Tatiana is Miss Gay Atlantic States America and is joining us from Alexandria, Virginia.
Her sponsors include John Parks and the Ziegfeld Secret Entertainment Complex, John Kane, Roger Dimmick, and the Miss Maryland family.
She is her own makeup stylist this evening, and Miss Vicky Vox is her hairstylist. Her gown designer is Jenny St. Cartier.
Her fundraising platform would be Hate Crimes.
She says this because hate crimes are becoming more frequent, a more frequent tragedy, and has an influent as and as an influential person in the gay community, I feel it would be her issue that should not be overlooked.
In her female persona, she's sometimes mistaken for Kathy Griffin.
I sometimes get mistaken for Kathy Lee Gifford. She says that the worst advice given to her by her mother is that Italian food can fix any mood. You know that one. And the best advice that was given to her by her promoter is that no matter what, they will be proud of her. Aw.
A song written that best applies to her life is One in a Million.
She says a favorite line from a movie, you show is ugly.
And the movie title that best describes her life is A Star is Born.
She says that she is most worried by Deb. Well, guess what, girl?
Your kitty died.
My cat's dead. Why are all these people so concerned about this? We gotta move on, people. Backstabbing and drama makes her sad.
And she sometimes gets angry when people do not follow through.
Follow through? I thought you said follow the groove. Says that performing makes her happy. Hi, ladies and gentlemen, an evening gown competition. This is contestant number 36, Miss Tatiana Vauché.
And Miss Keisha Lee Love will be doing on stage question.
Hey, I got you, boo. How you, boo? You doing all right?
Yes, I'm doing blessed. Thank you. How are you, Katia?
I'm doing well, thanks. All right, ladies. Don't start now. We have a pageant to do. Why don't you tell everybody a bit about yourself?
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My given name is Jonathan Jackson. Tonight, I bring you the illusion of Tatiana Vauché from the great state of Virginia. Thank you all so much for coming out tonight. I would like to personally thank my friends, my sponsors, and my two dads that are in the audience. I could not be on this stage without each and every one of you. Thank you so much.
Yes, the dads are out there. Fabulous. Well, one of these is the golden question, so be sure you pick it. Sadly, that was not it.
Sadly.
music's working me out, yeah. Considering that this country is known for its freedom, is censorship a good thing? Why or why not? Considering that this country is known for its freedom, is censorship a good thing? Why or why not?
Thank you, Tia. I don't believe censorship is a good thing. God made us the way that we are. We should be able to be exactly the person that we were meant to be. Censorship blocks that. I think that each one of us represents one person and to each their own. So yes, I think that censorship is not a good thing. Thank you, I'm contestant number 36, Tatiana Vosche.
Thank you, Tatiana. Good luck this evening. We would like beep to say very much that would beep.
I see Miss Jennifer Fox over there. She's writing. I just have to share a new memory. Last night was my first time I really got to work with Jennifer, and it really was a lot of fun. So thank you for all your wisdom. It was a great time.
Oh, that was awfully sweet.
Well,
do you owe her money? She giving me the stinker. Would you like a clamp? I found this. Would you like this? Well, I'm just trying to be nice. You want that? Go ahead. There you go. Where are you planning on putting that? This isn't one of them leather contests.
This is contestant number 39, Miss Gay Heart of America, Sasha Lee Chambers.
And Sasha is joining us as Miss Gay Heart of America 2010. And she hails from Atlanta, Georgia.
Her sponsors include Cocktail Entertainment, Mike Devokey, Rodney Brown, Wayne Doggett, Scorpios and Vaughn Entertainment, Ben Sweat, Jay Harrington, Melissa Kenyatta, and many family members and friends of Sasha Lee Chambers.
She says that she is her own makeup artist this evening, and her hairstyle is by Q of Atlanta, Georgia. Mr. Jimmy Wang is the designer of her evening gown.
In her female persona, she's sometimes mistaken for Bette Midler. And as she gets older, she feels more confident in the choices she makes.
The worst beauty advice she has ever received is that spray tanning never causes orange streaks. It causes brown streaks.
And the best beauty advice she's ever received is cover girl does not cover boy.
Well, maybe with 5 pounds of it, but that's kind of gets the point.
Didn't you used to use liquid foundation?
I sure did, to cover that zit, like the one on your shoulder. Don't try it, Queen. She says that the best advice given to her by her promoter is that you're only here to compete against yourself. Well, and 51 other people.
A song written that best applies to her life is I Am by Christina Aguilera.
And she says that she is most worried by war. Not death, but war. And that being with friends on game night makes her happy. Uno, anyone? Yahtzee? And hearing a friend tell a sad story makes her sad. And she sometimes gets angry when parents do not accept their children for who they are. Ladies and gentlemen, the poncho's flag has been raised. That is contestant number 39 in evening gown competition, Miss Sasha Lee Chambers. Guess what? You get me again. Taking over. Hi, Sasha. How are you?
I'm fine, Katia. How are you?
That's a fishy voice. That's fabulous.
Thank you so much. How are you doing?
Ooh, that changed. All right.
Hey, don't, oh no.
All right, why don't you tell everybody a bit about yourself, sweetheart?
Thank you, Katia. Good evening, ladies, gentlemen, and my most distinguished panel of judges. My name is Christopher Thomas, and I'm standing here creating the illusion of Sasha Lee Chambers representing Miss Heart of America. Ladies and gentlemen, I am just so ecstatic and thrilled to be standing here for the first time in top 10 at Miss Gay America. Thank you so much.
Well, congratulations on that, making the top 10 first time. There you go, Victoria. Why, thank you. Y'all ready for this? What is your definition of a symbol of excellence? Ladies and gentlemen, once again, what is your definition of a symbol of excellence?
Thank you, Katia. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and my most distinguished panel of judges. I'm your contestant number 39, Sasha Lee Chambers. My definition of the symbol of excellence is someone who follows their heart, their mind, their body, and their soul. An administrator, a dedicated professional in the art form of female impersonation, and someone who truly, truly follows their heart. Ladies and gentlemen, to me, that is my definition of a symbol of excellence. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen and judges,
Thank
let's
you,
hear
Sasha.
For contestant number 39, Miss Sasha Lee Chambers.
Isn't she lovely?
She is. Her face
I think they've
is
all been
so
absolutely
beautiful.
Lovely.
Let's hear for all 52 contestants who competed for Miss Gay America this week. You guys were all fabulous. I hope you had a wonderful time, and we do hope to see you back next year. Roger was the first person I ever met at Miss Gay America.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
Wow, he I don't was. Remember. Who was the first person I ever met? I don't remember, because I think she was mean. She didn't make the top 10. I did. I hate that for her. Makes me sad. Well, we have one more contestant in evening gown competition, ladies and gentlemen. Yes.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the stage contestant number 48, Miss Sally Sparkles.
And Sally is joining us as our first alternate to Miss Gay Heart of America. And she is from the Big D, Dallas, Texas.
Her sponsors include Mike Devokey and Rodney Brown of Cocktail Entertainment and the Miss Gay Heart of America family. Next Step Dance Academy, the Sally Sparkles Dancers, Nicole Hill, Rico
Cavalli. Oh, now I'm taking over. Okay, sorry, I wasn't watching. Rico Cavalli, Nadine Hughes, George Tagle, Richards, Riley Salatki, Mike and Linda Sharp, Monty and John, and many friends and family. Girl, you abandoned me to the hard names. She threw me under the bus.
Sally is her own makeup stylist. And her hair is done by Sweet Mark of Dallas.
This cracks me up. She says that she is sometimes mistaken for a Kim Kardashian wannabe.
As she gets older, she feels like her clothes are shrinking.
Amen, sister. Amen. Shoes are getting smaller, too. Oof.
The best beauty advice she'd ever received is to intensify.
The worst advice that was given to her by her mother? Little boys don't play with Barbie dolls. No, they dress those G.I. Joes up in drag. They dress them up in the Barbie clothes. That's what you do.
A song written that best applies to her life is It's My Time.
I thought you were being dramatic. She says that the best advice given to her by her promoter is do not give away points.
And And her favorite line or quote from a movie is, "A dream is a wish your heart makes," from Cinderella.
Dancing makes her happy, and closed-mindedness makes her sad. And she sometimes gets angry when she gets a run in her tights. It just sends me over the edge. Ladies and gentlemen, in evening gown competition, this is contestant number 48, Miss Sally Sparkle. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, and I do believe joining her for onstage question is the lovely Miss Nicole Dubois.
Thank you, Katia. Hi, Sally.
Hello, Miss Nicole. How are you doing?
I'm good. How are you doing?
I'm doing great. You look lovely.
And you as well. Well, welcome to the top 10 once again. We're going to let you tell everyone a little bit about yourself.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Sally Sparkles, also known as Michael Sharp. I'm originally from a small town in Texas called Copper's Cove, and I am so lucky because my mother has traveled from that little bitty town to come see me perform and compete at Miss Gay America. Thank you, Mama. I love you. And my Aunt Judy is right next to her. So if y'all see the two little dark-headed Asian women, they belong to me.
Okay, my love, this is onstage question. I'll let you choose a question, read it to yourself, and then I'll read it to the judges and the audience. As Miss Gay America, in what way could you be a mentor for a newcomer in female impersonation? Once again, as Miss Gay America, in what way could you be a mentor for a newcomer in female impersonation?
Thank you. I was lucky enough to meet Real Girl Miss Texas, Kristen Blair, 2009, and she said something that has stuck with me. She said, "You have that one night when you are crowned, and it's all about you. But after that, your reign is about everybody else." And I believe that is the same thing with Miss Gay America. You have that one special moment to realize what you have been bestowed, and after that, it is about everyone else. And by being a positive role model for everyone else is what Miss Gay America means to me. Thank you so much. I'm contestant number 48, Sally Sparkles.
Ladies and gentlemen, an on-stage interview, evening gown competition, contestant number 48, this is Sally Sparkles. Thank you,
yay.
Sally.
What would you guys think of evening gown competition and on-stage question?
Yes! That was lovely. Ooh, I bet they're breathing a little easier now. That's halfway through the competition,
ladies and gentlemen.
Yeah, where are all the parents at? Oh, I was going to say stand up, and everybody has stood up. Wow.
They have pushed right on out.
At this time, if you would please welcome to the stage, she was Miss Gay America 2004. This is Miss Rachel Aaron.